Welcome to another great episode of Burning for a Cure with your hosts, Joey Giggles and Barby Ingle. The Power of Pain Foundation is proud to be the premier sponsor for the show. The Power of Pain Foundation is a national 501c3 charity bringing medical information, educating patients, caregivers, and healthcare professionals, and supporting chronic pain patients with neuropathy pain conditions. Donations are tax deductible. For more information, please check out www.powerofpain.org. Through our Motivation for a Cure, we are turning pain to power. Enjoy the show.
Hey everybody, how's everybody doing today? Really exciting stuff right here on WYRN Internet Radio. This show is sponsored by Power of Pain Foundation. So right now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to bring on our co-host, Barby Ingle. Hey Barby, how you doing?
Hey Joey, I'm doing good today, thank you.
I would like to introduce our guest today. Yes, it's Charles Mattocks. And now Charles Mattocks, ladies and gentlemen, is the gentleman that's putting together the new documentary on RSD CRPS called Trial by Fire. So we're going to introduce him right now and bring him on. Hey, Charles, how you doing?
I'm doing well. Thank you for having me, Barby. Thank you so much. And I'm excited to be here today with you guys.
So glad that you had the time. I know that you're super busy and you had filming actually today for the documentary. So really appreciate that you took the time to come on the show today and help share what you're working on. I'm going to go ahead and jump into questions. So you're known as Celebrity Chef, and I'm going to talk about you first before we get into the documentary. I just want people to know your depth and what you have already accomplished. So you're known as a celebrity chef. You've been involved in some other TV shows and TV movies. And I was just wondering if you still enjoy cooking.
I do. I do. I love to go home and get on my own stove and make my own meals. I actually enjoy cooking than at home than eating out. So, no, I still love cooking, and we still do it. I've got a show that airs in about 15 islands right now, from Jamaica to Barbados to Bahamas. So we still have a cooking show that's airing right now that I get down and dirty every now and then.
Right. So, and you were diagnosed with type 2 diabetes. When did that occur? When did your diagnosis come?
That was about 4.5 years ago. Yeah, it was about 4.5 years ago. Yeah.
And how has that changed your diet and your lifestyle since being diagnosed?
It was actually an eye-opener, and it was for the best thing. Because, see, the thing is that, you know, once diagnosed, you then have to actually look at your health state. I could have gone on the way I was going for months or years and had a stroke or a heart attack and never, you know, had looked at where I was, you know, with my health. So being diagnosed kind of made me have to step back and say, okay, well, what are you eating? You know, how are you exercising? What are you drinking? You know, where's your cholesterol? Where's your blood pressure? So it was actually a blessing for me, because I was then able to look at it not only as a career-wise change, but also from a health perspective. And I've never been, you know, as healthy as I am now. So I look at it as a blessing. And I think people who are diagnosed with, you know, type 2 diabetes should also look at it in that respect and make some changes in your life. And that's what your body is telling you, that you need to make some changes.
Yeah, well, great that you've been able to manage it. I don't know if you can ever overcome it, but manage it. My father has diabetes, and he's actually struggling pretty bad and needing a kidney at this point. It affects internal organs, and he has the diabetic neuropathy pain as well from it. So was there any challenges with getting diagnosed, and how long did it take?
Well, it just came all of a sudden. I mean, for me, it was one of those things where I was using the bathroom a little bit too much over a weekend, and I thought, you know what, let me just go to a local Saturday clinic, because that's, you know, my doctor was closed on Saturday, and I literally went in there thinking that, you know, maybe I just had some bladder infection or a kidney infection or just, you know, just, of course, self-diagnosing myself, which none of us should actually do, and it turned into him coming back and saying, you know, do you have a family history of diabetes? And, you know, my eyes kind of lit up like diabetes. kids. I mean, which is a sad part, a black male in his 30s who knew nothing about diabetes. So I was beyond shocked and literally walked out of his office in just, I thought my life was over. You know, he wanted to give me medication, and I thought, wow, what just happened here? You know, and I, at that point I had had, good health insurance. I don't know how my doctor, who I saw every few months, overlooked stuff. So it was definitely a shock in the sense that, you know, you would think that there had to be some signs ahead of time before, you know, you walk into a stranger's office and he tells you you have diabetes.
Right. Does your insurance cover your, are you on any treatments or is it just lifestyle moderation? And does insurance cover
your...
Or having to take any?
No. I didn't even accept any medication. I walked out of there thinking there's got to be a better way. And and literally, when I tell you that moment, I said, you know what? I'm going to go back to what God gave us, and which was, you know, fruit, vegetables, and water. And for about a month and a half, I lost about 20 pounds. Just exercising, walking, changing my diet, and I've never been on medication. And see, so, you know, that's the thing that, especially when it comes to type 2, where there's a big gap as far as, you know, why people don't take it serious and why it progresses past, you know, being especially type 1. You know, type 2. Type 2 is a lifestyle, basically, condition. So if you change your lifestyle, you can, in a sense, you'll never get rid of it, but you'll reverse, like I like to call, reverse the forward progress of it. That's something that people don't take serious, and they let time slip by, and that's usually when you know you go into a stage of it progressing past the point of being able to really control it.
Right, like my father.
Yeah, unfortunately, people don't take it serious.
Go ahead.
Yeah, and what happens is that, you know, these doctors are so quick to just give medication that they don't educate. So they say, just go ahead and take this, and this person doesn't change their diet. They don't change all the bad habits. They're still eating the salt. They're still eating the fried foods. They just think that if they take this, that this is gonna. But you know, the diabetes attacks and destroys every organ in the body. So, you know, you need more than just something that's going to help control your blood sugars. You need things that are actually going to help coat and sustain and oil up, if you like to call it. You know, you have arteries and blood vessels that will harden from diabetes and high blood pressure and cholesterol. And so it's not just about taking, you know, diabetes medication and then thinking, okay, you know, this will help you. 80% of diabetics die from heart disease. So when you think about, yeah, you may be stabilizing your blood sugar, but you're still dying from other complications.
Right, right. And so you're a spokesperson for the American Diabetes Association, and they asked you to write...
Yeah, I'm a Blue Circle champion with the International Diabetes Federation, and I work hand-in-hand with the ADA, and I just released a cookbook with them.
Great. And so is it on sale? How can people get it?
It is. It's on sale on Amazon and all those websites, and you can go there and grab it. Just type my name in, Charles Mattocks, and cookbook, and the newest one will show up.
Great. Great. Okay, and so you did a whole documentary on diabetes already. So can you tell us what the name of it is and how it came about?
That one was called The Diabetic You, and we're still editing that one right there. That's a very big project. I've been shooting that for the past probably 3 years, but you know, and that's one that has taken us around the world, from India to Australia to the islands, and of course America. You know, diabetes is almost 400 million people with diabetes. So when you think about the gravity of what we're trying to show, you know, it has many other issues other than just being diagnosed with diabetes, other from a pharmaceutical standpoint, from a health provider standpoint, from a food standpoint, fast food standpoint. So it has from a patient standpoint. So it has so many different modalities that it's kind of hard to just wrap that up in a short period of time.
Right. Okay, so I guess I've seen the part on India, so I thought that the whole documentary was already done, but you're saying there's more to come?
Well, no, we're pretty much editing right now, so
okay.
we're close to wrapping that one up.
Okay, great. So let's talk a little bit about your newest project, Trial by Fire. And I know your mom, or I've heard that your mom has RSD or CRPS. I'm not sure if it's full body or regional. But can you tell us a little bit about your mom's experience and how you got involved in wanting to help the RSD CRPS community by making a documentary?
Yeah, she was. I remember she had. I think I want to say she fell. And, it probably was just a simple thing. I mean, don't think it was a major fall. She started to have these pains. And it took her, I want to say, probably about a year and a half to actually be diagnosed with, CRPS, RSD, after going and seeing all of these doctors and all of these people like that. And I remember, kind of thinking that this was all in her head and that she just needed to, walk it out and exercise and things like that. And didn't really connect with it, as, I've never heard of it before. And then started doing some research online. And, she was in, tremendous pain. And, obviously if someone is going through pain and you're not going through that same type of pain, it's hard for you to really understand what they're living with. And I had done some research online and looked up certain things. And, like I said, I still, for whatever reason, didn't really grasp the extent of it. And like I said, I used to just tell her, to be positive, that, she's got to work out, she's got to walk, she's got to try to, stretch it out and fight it and things like that. And, I'm sure she was thinking in her mind, he has no idea what he's talking about. So, just over time, over the last couple of years, I've seen her really kind of deteriorate. And, I remember reaching out to the RSD community and speaking to some people back about 2.5 years ago about, wanting to do something together. So I had this in my mind for some time. And then recently, I lost my father in November of 2015 just from cancer that just literally came out of nowhere. So, at looking at that and then realizing, my mother's state, because, at times, I don't think she would kill herself, but she does, has mentioned, she wished she wasn't here type of thing. And, mm-hmm. and just being in a bad state where, you look and you say, well, hey, I just had a father pass. So the last thing I want to see is a mother pass, and you don't want to see anybody pass. But I mean, to possibly have a mother and a father pass within a year or so of each other would be just a horrendous situation. But then also just because of the pain that she's going through and looking at that and saying, how can I help? So I remember probably a couple of months ago, this was maybe about 3.5-4 months ago, I was at her house, and she likes to have her feet in some warm water, so that gives her some kind of relief, with some Epsom salt or whatever like that. And, she had mm-hmm. gone through a couple of procedures that I thought were just very costly, and one of them was the nerve block, back stimulated nerve block, which I thought, I told her, I said, listen, I don't think that's a good idea. And it turned out it really just was about $15,000 worth of a trial that she ended up taking out in about 8 months. It did more harm than good, which it did for her. So then just, seeing doctors just kind of almost like she's a guinea pig, just trying this, trying that. I don't think things where she lives in Ocala, I don't think that any of them have a clue of what RSD or CRPS really is. And so, you've been seeing the tests go on, and the send them to here, send them to there, send them to there. And, just prescribing medication after medication after medication. And, almost to the point where it seems like she's addicted to this. this medication, you know, the morphine and all of this stuff. And so I remember one time she was at my house in Tampa, and she literally was ready to go back home at 11 o'clock at night just because she had left the medication. And it was like, you know, almost scary. So a couple months back, about 3.5 months ago, I was at her house, and I just went online, and I found a guy from Germany who posted a video about some stuff that he had found that was helping him with his, you know, RSD, CRPS. And so I thought, you know what, you know, this is what I do. I'm a doctor, a maker. I'm almost an advocate for people.
Hello? Hello?
Well, we unfortunately dropped Charles. Unfortunately, he fell off of the switchboard here. He'll be calling back in. But really interesting, Barby. Really interesting stuff so far that we've heard.
Sure.
Yeah, definitely.
I still have some more questions, but what he's talking about is mom and what she's going through. I still wonder what treatments that she's, because he said she was in severe pain every day. So I'm wondering what got her under control. And, you know, Joey, as a RSD patient, we all are guinea pigs.
Yeah, I know.
and so hearing, you know, all his mother has a very similar story. It you know, I stopped counting at over 100 providers and $1 million in medical bills in 13 years. I don't even count it anymore because it's just, you know, that's enough to say I've seen that many.
Yeah, so. I hear you. I was a guinea pig for Calamar and like two or three meds, you know, in the beginning of my RSD experience. So I know exactly what a guinea pig is all about. Trust me. So,
has he called back in yet?
Yes, he's back. So I'm going to bring him back.
Okay, great.
On. Yeah. All right, Charles is back, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. Hey, Charles.
All right.
Yeah.
Sorry about
that.
I don't know what happened,
that.
But
I'm
glad you're back.
I'm driving. Yeah. So yeah. So I saw a guy from Germany who had left a video, and he had some success with some different medications, and I kind of showed it to her, and I'm like, "Ma, you need to take a look at this, you know." And I don't know if she's kind of checked out in the sense where, you know, it doesn't seem like she, you know, really is so, you know, she's older, of course, so she doesn't really do all the research and things like that that I think that she should. So at that point, I just really said, you know what, I'm going to do something, and I'm going to create something here that could not only be a testament, you know, for her, but for the others who seem like there's no voice, there's no, you know, person that, you know, is really, you know, I mean, of course, you guys do a great job, but, you know, our CRPS really needs, RSD needs one of those things that really take it to the next level. So I thought, you know what, I'm gonna do this. So I kind of started to reach out to a couple of big organizations, and I don't know if they didn't take me serious. I think they did, but I don't think they thought I would probably get where I'm at now or be doing what I'm doing now. So I approached a couple of them, and you know, the big ones that you guys all know. And, you know, it didn't get very far, you know. It was like, you know, so, and then one of them actually wanted me to team up with some videographer that they had, and this lady just seemed very weird to me, and I'm like, you know what, I'm just going to do this on my own. I don't need anybody. I'll just get it done whichever way that I can and create, you know, something that can be a great piece. So, you know, just engulfing myself in the CRPS community, RSD community, has been, for me, very, very thrilling. And I say that because, you know, working with diabetes, where, you know, especially with type 2, it's a lifestyle condition. So, you know, a lot of people don't want to change their lifestyle, and so they're not aware of where they're at. It really doesn't mean anything to them, right, because they're going to eat the same way, they're going to eat their fast food, they're going to do all the things that they have to do, and that's it. But, you know, with this condition, I've seen the outpouring of love. At times, trust me, I work with diabetes, and sometimes I question myself, and I say, you know, why am I really doing this? Because these people don't even say thank you. I mean, it's one of those things where you can work your behind off and travel around the country and travel around the world, and you don't get too many "we thank you, Charles, for all the work that you're doing." So working with, you know, CRPS and RSD in this community has been amazing because of the response that we're getting. You know, we really seeing some of these stories that I must say are just gut-wrenching, that just, you know, just tear at your heart and every fabric in you. I mean, just, you know, as you said, we're filming right now, and I just left a young girl named Natalia and filmed with her and her mother, and wow, I mean, it's almost speechless because you don't know what to say as far as, you know, where this young girl goes from here, because, you know, it's there's not a lot of options as far as where she goes from here, to be honest. You know, that's how bad the situation is, and there are so many like this. But, you know, the good thing is that it seems like everybody we've talked to in the community really wants to see this happen, really wants to see this be made. So it's been very rewarding working with a community that wants to see something like this come, you know, come to fruition and get where it needs to be. So, you know, so for me, it started about my mother, but mm-hmm. to be honest, it's really about the amazing so-called, I want to call them friends. I mean, I mean, I've got people who are WhatsApping me, texting me, Facebooking me, emailing me now, who I feel like I've met a whole new set of friends, and I'm just excited to be a part of creating this voice, and hopefully that you know, we'll do very well. You know, my goals for this is to win a ton of awards, and like I said, if you would have saw what we shot today. There's no doubt in my mind that we will do very well and that we will get picked up by either, you know, the likes of a CNN or something to that effect that will carry this program and allow millions of people around the world to see it.
That's great. How much does it cost to put this program together?
Well, you know, that's the thing. I mean, what it should cost is a whole lot more than what we're looking for, you know. And you know, when you talk about costs, you know, if you look at a movie, let's say you look at a Will Smith movie, you know, right away, if you got the director, he's got to walk away with $5 million, right? Right away, Will Smith has got to walk away with $60 million. So right there, you got $65 million right in the hole before you even think about anything else. So the thing with this is, you know, we're looking for around $8,500, $9,000, somewhere around here. But, you know, and that's just literally just going into production and shooting and editing. And, you know, it can be very costly. You know, I mean, I work with, you know, professionals who have families, and, you know, to take somebody away from me, you know, for some time, whether it's a day or a week, is, you know, they have to also figure out and realize that, you know, they have bills to pay to as well. So,
right.
You know, the money we were looking for is really just to cover the cost of filming and editing. And, you know, editing is also a very expensive thing. It may take somebody 3 weeks to edit something, and that's somebody working, you know, pretty much, you know, night and day, trying to put together the pieces and edit the clips and adjust sound and adjust coloring and make the story come together and things like that. So it's very tedious, but like I said, this is a labor of love, and it's more about just getting it done than it is about looking for our reward will come from the smiling faces, because, perfect example, seeing Natalia and her mom, she was so happy to see us at her house today. I mean, you know, you can't put a price tag on that, you know, and, you know, you're talking about a young girl who wants to share her story, who's sitting in bed in pain, you know, with tubes, you know, she can't even eat right now because she, you know, has to be fed through a tube. So when you think about someone like that who you're able to, you know, I mean, before I left, she said, I'm really going to be featured in this. And I said, you're going to be one of the stars, not just, you know. She said, you sure? I said, of course. You know, so, you know, to see that, know that we can tell this little young girl's story, but then other people can see their story through her. can't put a price tag on that, you know. So that's why we really encourage everyone to get behind this that's in the CRPS community, because, you know, I understand the times are tough for everybody, and a lot of folks aren't working because of the condition, but everybody's got $1, right? And if there's 1.5 million people and counting with CRPS, we only need a few thousand put in $1, you know. So, you know, that this is very doable. This is, we're not looking for you to put $100 or $50 or $20, $1, and just show other people that you support. Because you got to remember, this is really for the people. And if the people can't support the people, then it doesn't really work. You know, we've got to, you know, when I first looked at the GoFundMe platform, which we're on, I went on there and I see people raising $25,000 for a dog, you know, and all kind of, you know, to raise a Confederate flag, they raise $50,000. To do the most crazy of things, people are raising, you know, $50,000, $100,000, $35,000, $40,000, you know, so we should have no problem, to be honest, raising $8,000 to shoot and direct and edit a movie based on a condition that really needs a voice. So, you know, I really ask the people to, you know, because what I'm looking for, too, is to create a movement. And that's really what we're trying to do here. Not just, I'm not just looking to do this documentary and then that's it. I'll see you guys later. I want to be engulfed in what you guys are doing and be a part of the whole movement. I mean, this really means a whole lot to me. You know, CRPS can happen to any of us at any time. And I really want to be a part of the movement and hope to continue to have the love and be embraced by the community.
Great. So what are the next steps for the project? What's coming up in the near future for it?
Well, we're going to be done pretty soon. We only have, you know, another week or so of shooting. You know, we had a great day today. We've got a ton of coverage. We're going to head back out with Natalia when she goes to get ketamine. And then we're going to film that process. And then we're also going to film the doctor who's doing the ketamine on her to kind of get a full grasp and understanding of what, you know, CRPS and RSD is from a clinical standpoint. Then we also are going to get my mother, who has never had ketamine. So, you know, she's the sister of Bob Marley. So I think that's also going to add a bit of credibility to, you know, the disease, the condition. So we're going to get her to, you know, Dr. Hanna's office out here in Clearwater and get her some treatment. And I think she probably will do very well with it. And then we're going to feature another person that is going to be probably an older person who is dealing with CRPS. So we'll have a few different viewpoints of what, you know, CRPS from, we'll have it from a young girl's standpoint. We'll have it from, you know, a woman who actually is, you know, used to be a business professional and her standpoint. And then also from my mother's perspective as far as, you know, what a son is trying to do for, you know, his mother. And then, of course, we've asked people to submit videos. So we're gonna play around with as many videos as we can to kind of tell some stories and you know, even though they're rough, but we'll put them in such a way that really kind of showcases some of the people around the world who have been sending us videos and want to be a part. And who knows, you know, we're hoping to raise as much as we can, because we'd like to travel outside of Florida. Obviously, with the budget that we have, you know, we can't go too far outside of Florida. So we're hoping that we are able to raise a little bit money and more money and possibly take a trip somewhere to film with another doctor or group or person of interest.
Hey, Charles, are you still accepting videos?
Yeah, we sure are. They can email me at info@thepoorchef.com, thepoorchef.com, or they can go to our website, which is trialbyfiremovie.com, and they can send them via our email address on the website.
Okay. I'll be sending a video in, just so you know.
Thanks,
all right,
brother.
No problem. We have a caller online, so we're going to bring on the caller. We also have 12 minutes remaining, so we're going to bring on the caller right now. Let's check it out. Hello, caller, you're on the air.
Hi.
Hi.
My name is Hi, this is Allison.
Hi, Allison.
How are you?
Okay.
I am calling to see if we'll be exploring Western and Eastern ways of pain management. Because I'm hearing, you know, a lot of the ketamine and the infusions and things like that, which I've done and tried all of that myself. But I've also felt that my body responds better to more natural treatments. Will that be talked about in the film?
Hey, Allison. Thanks for the question.
Hey.
You know, great question. You know, right now we are basically focusing on what we can focus on right now.
Correct.
You know, because once again, we're under budget constriction. So, you know, unless we find a doctor that is in, you know, the local Orlando, Tampa area who is doing other forms of treatment, it's really hard for us to get that perspective. So, because once again, you know, we're working on, you know, very limited budget here. So,
mm-hmm.
you know, ketamine seems to be what is working for a lot of people, even if it's in a small way. For some people, it's done tremendous things. But I think, you know, when we look at what the film really is about, it's really about the inspirational side of things, and really just giving, you know, CRPS a voice to be recognized. You know, I'm not the end that justifies the means. What I'm trying to do is really just allow, you know, use my platform of television and media to kind of get the word out there so that, you know, you guys can now have a bigger voice to be able to draw some attention and keep things going. But, you know, I would love to have a lot of different angles on things. But once again, unless we find someone, or maybe you even know someone, you know someone in the local Tampa, Orlando, Clearwater, or Kissimmee area, or whatever it may be, a St. Pete area, that is into alternative forms of treatment, you know, feel free to send them our way so that we can interview them, because, you know, we would love to have their perspective
mm-hmm.
on things.
Okay. I see. Yeah. Oh, well, thank you for the answer. I appreciate it. This all seems to be coming out of Florida, so I understand that.
Yeah, like I said, I would love to travel. You know, I mean, we're trying to, you know, unfortunately, like the same thing that I deal with diabetes. You know, there's billions of dollars in healthcare, and you know, trying to get $20 out of some of these people who have billions doesn't always go well. And you know, sometimes you even want to reach out to some of these doctors who, let's face it, we all know they're doing very well. And
mm-hmm.
you know, to get $1,000 out of a doctor who is you know, living a good life, it seems to be like pulling teeth. So you know, if we can get one or two of them to open up their wallets and say, hey, you know what, we'd love to be in here, because, you know, to be honest, being featured on this film, on this documentary, for whichever doctor we feature, could literally change their business. You know,
right.
They can bring in hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Mm-hmm.
just on being featured on a documentary. So you would think that they would want to invest or really be more open to putting a few dollars into seeing this done,
right.
Considering that the people need this. But, you know, it's the fight that you have with you know, with healthcare, with people in general. And like I said, I deal with
mm-hmm.
it in diabetes, and you know, like I said, hopefully something will come through. I mean, you know, Barbie and Joey and some really great people that have come step forward. And I think that, you know, in a short period of time, we've actually done amazing. I mean, this is going on in a couple of weeks, and we've done tremendous. So I think as we continue to shoot over the next 2 weeks, and we continue to grow and the message gets out even more. I think that, you know, there will be other doors that will open up that will possibly allow us to get to other places, to see other doctors, to tell this other stories. But if mm-hmm. not, you know, we'll be across the country with film festivals, and, you know, wherever you're at, I'm sure we may have one, and you can come out and support, and we can, you know, do local television and radio and media and things like that, and we can make the best out of what we have, because it's still going to be a great piece. That's one good thing about
yeah.
it. It's still going to be a beautiful piece.
I'm in the Philadelphia, PA area.
Okay.
But my doctor does frequently travel, and he has done some traveling in Florida. So I want to talk to him. You said Orlando area, St. Pete?
Orlando, Tampa, yeah, St. Pete. Yeah, so if you want to talk to him and, you know, tell him about what we're doing and if he's going to be this way, or if he wants to send us that would be fantastic as well.
I'm sorry, that last piece was cut off.
I said if he wants to come this way, but if he wants to send us 2 round trip tickets, we'd love to come that way too as well.
All right. I'll let him know. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much, Allison. Take care.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
All right. So I want to bring on the next caller. Remember, we only have 6 minutes remaining in the show. We have another caller. Hello, caller. You're on the air.
Hi, this is Kristen.
Hi. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm well. Thank you.
This is more of just a comment, not really a question. I just wanted to thank Charles as a 26-year patient of RSV. I think it's the first time real awareness is being brought out. We spoke yesterday, and as I told you, I've had this since I was 12 years old. And back in 1990, there was no information about RSV. So the fact that now doctors can learn people.
Okay. We're breaking up there, caller. Paul, you're breaking up. All right. Unfortunately, we won't get the end of those comments. The caller was dropped unless she calls back. We only
Charles,
have 5 minutes.
Charles, can you go over where people can find out more information again?
Yes.
Yeah, they can go to the website, which is trialbyfiremovie.com. That's trial, T-R-I-A-L, by, B-Y, fire, F-I-R-E, movie.com. Or they can go to our Facebook page, which is basically, you know, Trial by Fire, Facebook.com, / Trial by Fire. Or they can go to my personal website, and email is there, and we'll send them something, which is Charles Mattocks, MattockS.com. But I definitely got to thank you guys. I know you're on limited time, but, you know, Joey, you came on board and supported us right away, not only with the kind words and tweets and even put a couple of dollars into the fund. So I want to thank you for that, now having us on the radio show. And Barbie, I got to say, you have... You know, I don't think people realize that, you know, your donation really spoke for probably a good couple of hundred people that you know, would have needed to donate even a small amount. So with that, we're able to really have gotten that boost that we needed to continue and move forward and continue shooting. So, you know, we definitely thank you for, you know, opening the door and showing us that love and support. And you know, if we had a few more Barbies out here and Joey's, boy, we could really change the world, not just for CRPS, but just for humanity. So I think that I thank you guys for allowing me to be a part of this amazing, awesome mission in this lovely community.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, really, Charles, because this is what we need for this community, you know. I mean, we've been searching for something like this for a while, and this is definitely something that we need, you know, to get RSD, CRPS out there more to the folks out there that are ignorant and don't understand, you know, RSD, CRPS. I think that's the main thing, is to actually get people that don't understand about RSD, CRPS, people that don't have it, to to understand it.
Yes.
And the only way to understand it, I think, is through this film. I want to thank you. I think it's awesome that, you know, you're putting this together. Hey, man, I'm rooting for you to win an Oscar. All right, so come on. All right?
You know what? I think, like I said, I mean, with the footage that we shot today, and the footage we shot the other day as well, I think, and the footage that we have coming up is, if we don't win every award around the country, I don't know who will, you know, I mean, this is, and I think the subject matter is really strong too as well, because it is a condition that most people have never heard of. It does affect family, because even like today, you have a mother who basically has to stop working to take care of her 14-year-old daughter. And to be honest, she's going to be taking care of her for probably the rest of her life.
Yeah. Barbie, any final comments? Barbie?
I just once again, thanks for coming on as our guest today for Burning for a Cure. You seem to have a similar mission to Power Pain Foundation. This is something that, you know, we've been working for almost 9 years now to raise awareness and make a difference and make a change. And we see it happening year after year, but this is one giant step that you're putting out there that would be able to do, help us as well. So we're helping you. And it's a great thing.
We're all family now. That's how I look at it, you know.
And we love that you want to be a part of our community, and we'll welcome you in with open arms, my friend.
Thank you. It's like I said, it's one big family now. You know, I'm here, you know.